Well, hi, everyone. Welcome to the Buffett and Beyond Research Stock of the Week. And we're looking at June 1st already. And this is Arista Networks. And boy, oh boy, this stock is up 75% in the past 12 months alone. And remember, folks, if you want to live on this beach like Jimmy Buffett, or I should say have lunch on this beach like Jimmy Buffett once did, you've got to learn how to invest even better than Warren Buffett does now. And this week, well, Arista is a leading supplier of cloud networking solutions. There's a big word there. For large-scale internet companies, cloud service providers, and data centers. That's been the term that those semiconductors from NVIDIA are going to, those data centers. Now, these solutions include its extensible operating system, a set of network applications, and its 1040/100 gigabyte Ethernet switches. And folks, that's the big word out there these days, the Ethernet. So these products are sold through both a direct sales force and channel partners. And it has a strategic partnership with VMware, which was almost in our portfolio, to advance the adoption of network virtualization. It has approximately 3,600 employees. So it's a big company, but not a real big company like we're used to seeing in our portfolios. And let's look at the statistics overall. And the green vertical lines are Arista. The blue vertical lines are the average stock in the S&P 500. Now remember, 96% of professional money managers cannot outperform the S&P 500. So we don't like to call it an average because it's not average. It's very, very difficult to outperform it. But so let's compare stocks that do outperform it, because since our portfolio outperforms the S&P 500 almost on a 3-to-1 compounded basis, that's important, compounded basis, over the past 22 years, well, we're doing something right in here, and that is to pick better than average stocks. And here's Arista. When we look at the clean surplus return on equity and think of your bank account, would you want to put your money in a bank account that's paying you 13.5% or one that's paying you 24%? Yeah, I think there's not much of a question there. The net income, this company has really been bringing net income to the bottom line. So in other words, it's been making revenue of 26%, where the average stock up 7.1%. And it's bringing so much of that to the bottom line that it is really, really outshining the other stocks out there in investment land. Now, when we look a little closer, first thing we want to do is we want to look at the clean surplus return on equity. Remember what clean surplus is. You take the traditional accounting earnings and you subtract any non-recurring liabilities. And folks, what does that mean? Non-recurring items means items that are not in your everyday expenses or your yearly expenses or your monthly expenses or expenses that are part of the normal operation of the company. That's why they call it clean surplus, because surplus, of course, stands for profits, and clean means we're cleaning it up so we can compare Arista to Meta, to Google, to Microsoft, and that's what clean surplus is all about. And yes, we've written books on it, a couple of books, and a doctoral dissertation on the subject, so we know quite a bit about it. And we want to, and remember, the average stock is about 13%, and Arista is above 20%, because our threshold is an arbitrary 20%. So it gives us a little moat that Buffett likes to talk about a lot. In other words, the difference between 13% for the average stock and the 20% to get into our portfolio. So we look at stocks with 20% or higher clean surplus return on equity. Now, I want to show you something over here. This is net income, and these are the clean surplus earnings. And this 658 has been raised just recently. They said, yep, when we looked at the fourth quarter of 2023, it made more than we expected it to. For 2024, they just raised this number again, so the company is making more than it was expected to make in 2024, at least so far. And for 2025, up to $7.75 a share. Now, don't forget, back in 2019, it was making about one-third of that. So this company is definitely growing. What we worry about, let's come over here to net income and revenue growth. For 2025, the revenue growth, 8.9%, is still above the average stock of about 7%. The only problem is that the net income growth, or the earning clean surplus earnings growth, is 4.7, which is quite a ways below the average of the past several years. So that has us a little, not worried about it, but we're looking at it and saying, how come it's not growing faster? But don't forget, it's come off a 2022 62% increase, a 2023 54% increase. So to beat these numbers, it takes a lot. But still, we're looking at that. But the market, it doesn't seem to bother the market. And we'll show you why in a second, as soon as we go to the next slide. But right now, the retention rate, 100%, that means everything that they're making, they're putting back into the company in order to grow. Over here, years to pay debt. Buffett's rule of thumb is if a company takes all the money it's making and uses it to pay off its debt, how many years will it take to do it? His rule of thumb is 5 years or less. Our rule of thumb is 3 years or less. And folks, this company has no debt at all. So years to pay debt, we don't even have to worry about it. What does that do? That protects it against increase in interest rates because it doesn't have to pay off the debt. Companies that have a lot of debt with interest rates rising have a problem because that means they cannot put money back into itself in order to grow if it has to pay a lot of interest on its debt. This company has no debt, don't have to worry about it, takes all the money it makes and puts it back into itself in order to grow. Now, how's this company done over the past 1 year? Black line down here is the S&P 500, up about 28-27%, and Arista, and that stock symbol is ANET, is up 75%. Now you can see where it was falling off, but then all of a sudden it surprised the market. And of course the market was falling off a bit also too. So this stock fell and then all of a sudden it came out with surprising numbers and wham, went back right up to new all-time highs. So we like that. And now it's dropped off a little bit. But that 4% growth that we were talking about before for next year, it doesn't seem to be bothering the market at all. They're saying, okay, we like it. We like what this company's doing. It's getting more orders. And even though it's only increasing its income, or I should say its profit by 4% for next year, it's been averaging about 33% a year over the past 5 years. So the market says, yeah, iCloud, that's the place to be. And that Ethernet that they're talking about is very, very strong. And then when we look over 5 years, yeah, black line again, S&P 500 up about 80%, this stock up 400%. It's very, very close to all-time highs. As I'm recording this, we're going through a correction in the market, and we expect, all the stocks are pretty much falling for a little bit. But yeah, it's coming off all-time highs, which is very, very nice. And the important thing is it came back from disappointment in the market. When the market did go down, see down here, it did go down a little bit. And then all of a sudden, the company came out with surprising numbers and it shot to the new highs again. So we like that, folks. Well, all right, folks, we had a tough week this week, a good month overall for May, but the market has been coming down the past 2 weeks or so and doing a correction. We expect it to last maybe another 2 weeks, about to the middle of June, and then we expect a run into the September-October period, and then another run after that because we have an election coming on and we kind of think the Fed will reduce interest rates at least once, maybe just before the election. I may be thinking the wrong things here, folks, but anyway, I think we do know that the political parties are going to be spending a lot of money out there, and that goes throughout the economy. So we'll see what happens, but we do expect a drop in interest rates at least once this year, and it will be probably just before the election. So we'll see. The market likes it. Market has hope of that. And don't forget, the market is just trading a few percent off all-time highs. So we're looking good out there. Meanwhile, go out for the weekend. Enjoy yourself. Be with your family. Be with your loved ones. And yes, we'll be right back here with you next week or this coming week as the market opens back up again. Okay, folks, take care and stay safe.